Welcome to the Gamer's Closet. I'm your host, Douglas Weed, and today we're going to be talking about Stratego. Stratego is a classic war game which has been around for decades. The game is still currently in print today. The game is a two-player strategy game with a memory game aspect to it because you can't see your opponent's pieces, so you do have to remember where they are. The object of this game is to capture your opponent's flag. The game itself runs for about 30 minutes. And like I said, it is a classic game, so you can find it at most retail stores, online. It's very easy to get a hold of. The edition I have here next to me is the edition from 1977 with the old general on it. The game has a Napoleonic military look to it, but let's dig into it a little further, shall we?
This is Stratego, not a place, not a time, but a battle of wit and skill and strategy. Stratego, we're generals, field marshals, scouts and lieutenants, miners and spies all conspire with bombs and brains to capture the enemy flag, to win the battle, to win the game. Get Stratego from Milton Bradley. Victory awaits you.
The game Stratego was registered and trademarked in the United States in 1960 and was licensed to the Milton Bradley Company, which put out their first edition in 1961. This edition came with wooden pieces, but this edition had a flaw with the wooden pieces as they were not sturdy enough and were consistently able to fall over and cause domino effects on the table. Every subsequent edition after that was redone in plastic with smaller bases with little feet to keep them from tipping over, as the classic style Stratego sits today. The game itself was originally created by Jacques Johann Mogendorf in sometime prior to World War II. It has changed hands several times throughout the years, including the Hossmann and Hot Company of Amsterdam, and finally in 2009 was purchased by Jumbo Games, also based out of Holland. The game itself also has a World International Gaming Federation, where they do hold world championships every year. It is in several different languages, which also includes Greek, Hebrew, and the Soviet Union actually put out a copy in Russian sometime in the early 1980s. When discussing Stratego, one other game does need to be mentioned. Les Attaques is a French game that was manufactured in 1910 and was subsequently reprinted in England during the First World War. The game runs with cardboard pieces. All the pieces have more of a modern type of uniform, unlike the Napoleonic pieces of the time, but the rules are exactly the same as Stratego. The game comes with two different colored playing pieces, red and blue. The colorful playing pieces are marked according to military rank, which are kept hidden from the opponent as they are placed and moved across the board to capture your opponent's flag. The rank of the piece is revealed only when the opposing player is struck or attacked. The higher ranked piece removes the lesser rank. There are bombs, which blow up and remove any attacking piece except for the miner, who can dismantle and remove bombs. Even the marshal, which is the highest ranking piece in the game, has a weakness, and that is the lowly spy can remove them from the game. The exciting elements of skillful planning, clever deception, memory, and suspense make Stratego a thoroughly delightful game. To start the game, place the board between the players so that the name Stratego is facing each player. One player takes red, the other one takes blue. Red starts first. Each player gets an army of 40 pieces in order of the rank from highest to lowest, consisting of one marshal, one general, two colonels, three majors, four captains, four lieutenants, four sergeants, five miners, eight scouts, and one spy. These are all movable pieces. There are also six bombs and one flag, which are not movable. It's also good to point out that the movable pieces have a number in the top left corner to designate the order of rank. Thus, the marshal is ranked number one, which is the highest, the general two, the colonel three, and so on to the spy, which is marked with an S. The players place one piece in each square on their half of the board. All squares are to be filled from each end, that is 10 per row, 4 rows deep. The two middle rows are to be left unoccupied at the start of the game. The pieces are placed with the notched ends up and the printed emblem facing the player in such a way that the opponent does not know the arrangement of the pieces. Gameplay alternates one move at a time, first red, then blue. Pieces move from square to square, one square at a time. The exception to this rule is for the scout, which I will go over in a moment. The pieces move forward, backward, or sideways, but never diagonally. Please note that there are two lakes in the center of the board which contain no squares. Pieces may not enter the lakes at any time. Two pieces may not occupy the same square at the same time. A piece may not move through a square occupied by a piece, nor jump over a piece. Only one piece may be moved each turn. The flag and the bomb pieces cannot be moved. Once these pieces are placed at the start of the game, they must remain in that square. The scout may move any number of open squares forward, backward, or sideways in a straight line if the player desires. This movement, of course, then reveals to the opponent the value of that piece. Therefore, the player may choose to move the scout only one square in their turn so as to keep the scout's identity hidden. The scout is valuable for probing the opponent's positions. The scout may not move and strike in the same turn. Once a piece has been moved to a square and the hand removed, it cannot be moved back into its original position in that turn. Pieces cannot be moved back and forth between the same two squares in the three consecutive turns. A player must either move or strike on their turn. When a red or blue piece occupy adjoining squares, either back-to-back, side-to-side, or face-to-face, they are in a position to attack or strike. No diagonal strikes can be made. A player may move on their turn or strike on their turn. They cannot do both. The strike ends the turn. After pieces have finished the strike move, the player who was struck has their turn to either move or strike. It is not required to strike when two opposing pieces are in the position to do so. A player may decide to strike whenever they want. To strike or attack a player, whoever's turn it is, takes up their piece and lightly strikes the opponent's piece while at the same time declaring their piece's rank. The opponent answers by naming the rank of their piece. The piece with the lower rank is lost and removed from the board. The winning higher ranking piece is then moved immediately into the empty square formerly occupied by the losing piece. Whenever equal ranks are struck, both pieces are lost and removed from the board. A marshal removes a general removes a colonel removes a major, and so on down to the spy, which is the lowest ranking piece. The spy, however, has the special privilege of being able to remove only the marshal, provided they strike first. That is, if the spy strikes the marshal on their turn, the marshal is removed. However, if the marshal strikes first, the spy is removed. All other pieces remove the spy regardless of who strikes first. When any piece, except for a minor, strikes a bomb, that piece is lost and removed from the board. The bomb does not move into the empty square, but remains in its original position at all times. When a miner strikes a bomb, the bomb is lost and the miner removes into the unoccupied square. A bomb can never strike, but rather must wait until a movable piece strikes it. Please note, if a player cannot move a piece or strike on their turn, they must give up and declare their opponent the winner. To end the game, a player has to strike the opponent's flag. Well, this has been an overview of Stratego. Like I said, it is a classic strategy game. If you're new to strategy games, I highly recommend picking this one up. If you have kids, again, highly recommend picking it up. It is a great game to learn on. If you haven't played strategy games before, it is a great game to play with your kids. I spent a lot of time as a child playing this with my dad and loved every second of it. The game is very easy to learn. It is very easy to pick up. It runs for about $20 online, even this edition here. It doesn't change from edition to edition. It just changes theming. But like I said, it is very easy to pick up. So if you haven't played Stratego before, I highly recommend picking it up and playing this game. Well, that's it from us here at the Gamer's Closet. We'd like to thank you for checking out our video on Stratego from Milton Bradley. If there's a game that you would like us to discuss or review in the future, please put it in the comments below. Please hit the subscribe button so that way you can be the first person to check out our future content. And as always, please have a great gaming day.